So now that we've learned the basis on how to look at event frames in PyVision, let's move on to the directed activity of process downtime. So we built the tank details display earlier. So let's inspect what happened with our mixing tank 1. So once opening the display, we can just open the events pane. And we're asked to find the most recent closed event for mixing tank 1. So if I look at the events here, I can see that this is my most recent event. So we're asked to get the reason code for this event. So what's great is that we have all the attributes down here. So we can look at the reason code. In this case, the reason code is scheduled downtime. Well, this is good. This was scheduled. Let's now inspect a little bit more of the details of this event. So clicking the event details will open up the event detail page here. And then we can get the value of the flow rate when it started and when the event ended. So in this case, on the trend currently, I only have the percentage full and the tank status, but I can add any other attributes. So I simply have to browse to the flow rate. By clicking on flow rate, I'm now adding it to the trend. So I can see it here on my trend, and I can also see the value when the event started and the value when the event ended. So in my case, the flow rate when the event ended was 198.8 US gallon per minute. I can also look at the difference between the two temperatures. So maybe I want to remove the flow rate from the trend. I want to add the external temperature and the internal temperature. So now I could compare the difference between the internal and the external temperature over time. So I can see that the end values were 254.2 and 138.0. So this is a really quick way to be able to really see that event. I can see the event type, and I can see that it was a warning event. Now that we found one event, let's try and compare it with similar events of the same type. So same type being downtime events. So here I can have the list of all the events. So we're asked to get the longest event, because this is the one that we want to track. We want to minimize downtime, therefore let's start with the one that has the longest amount of downtime. So if I click on it, it will automatically update the graphs here. And I can see that the brown line here is my longest event. I can also see the event duration. So in this case, this event lasted 16.5 minutes. And I can see that we had a lost production of over 1,600 US gallons. So since this was my longest, let's bin this event. And now let's go search for all the other tanks. So I can go search for any asset name. So I've now updated all the results here. So if I want to see again, in this case, the new longest event would be this one here. So this is a really quick way to browse through different events and see really what's important. And we can always note the severity of the event. And we can see that we have some red, therefore critical events. And then we have some warning events. So this covers the basis of event frames in PyVision, but the great thing with event frames is that you'll be able in your plan to see the way your event frames were based and be able to really get some information and see what has happened and maybe compare from bad events to good events. And then you can go and see the root cause of those events by noting the start and the end time of those times.